Well, hi there. Welcome to Paint and Zoo. My name is Matt, and you're joining me today here in our Crocodile Swamps exhibit. Okay, I think you might be looking at habitats at school, so we thought you might like to come and see the habitats that we've got here at the zoo. Now, the first thing to start with, really, is to try and understand what the word habitat means. Now, if I asked you, what is your habitat, what would you think? Have a little look around you and have a ponder. Talk with the person next to you, if there's somebody nearby, and think, what does habitat mean? If you're talking to a scientist, then when they're talking about habitat, then they think about the place where a living thing lives. Okay, and if I asked you where your habitat is, okay, then you might say your house or your home or your bed. I'm sure a lot of you would like to spend as much time as possible in your bedroom. But actually, for an animal, a habitat is a little bit bigger than that. Okay, a habitat is where an animal or a living organism finds everything that it needs: shelter, food, water, a social life if it needs one, and a mate. Okay, so all the things that it needs to survive. So for you, your habitat is going to be a little bit bigger than just your bedroom. It's going to be perhaps the places where you move between your house, okay, where you've got shelter and friends and your family. It's going to be where your shops are, where you get your food, and also your school, where your social life is. So if you imagine that your habitat is the place where you move between those three things, my habitat would be where I've got my house and my work, and also where I've got my friends as well, so, and the shops, so that's where my habitat is, okay, in Devon. Now, can you think of any habitats? I want you to try and think of three different habitats that you've heard about. So, if you've got, let's give you 15 seconds, and I want you to turn to the person next to you, or if you're working on your own, then I want you to write these answers down on a piece of paper and try and name three different habitats around the world. You've got 15 seconds, starting in 3, 2, 1, go. Now, you could have come up with lots of different answers about different habitats around the world, but we're going to be looking at three particular ones today. Now, here at the zoo, we've got lots of animals that live in a rainforest, we've got lots of animals that live in the savannah, and we've even got some that live in the desert. So we're going to be looking at those three habitats today, but you could have also come up with lots of different habitats, things like mountain habitats, or ocean, or coastal, or even urban. Okay, there are animals that live in habitats in around the world, and it's really important that we know a little bit about their lives in the wild so that we know how to look after them. Can you imagine what would happen if we kept a rainforest millipede in a desert exhibit? What would happen if we kept something like a desert tortoise in a puddle? Well, that wouldn't work, would it? It wouldn't help to keep them healthy. So by knowing a little bit about the habitats that our animals live in the wild, it helps the keepers to look after them properly here at the zoo. Now, we're going to think about the desert first, okay? So I want you to think of some words that it's like that will describe what it's like in the desert. So describing what the environment is like there. So if you're working with somebody, then I want you to turn to them and have a little brainstorm with them for 15 seconds. If you're working on your own, then I want you to write down some answers on a piece of paper. So what's it like in the desert? I want you to come up with some simple words that just describe what it's like there. You've got 15 seconds starting in 3, 2, 1, go. Now, I wish I could see the words that you've written down, but I'm hoping you've got the word dry there. Because when we think of deserts, we always think of them as hot places. You may well have written hot or boiling, but actually, the important thing about desert is that it's dry. It may not rain for years on end. Deserts can be hot or cold, but they're always dry. Now, if you go to certain deserts, maybe the Sahara, okay, and I've traveled there, then it can be boiling hot in the daytime, but freezing cold at night. Other deserts, maybe the Gobi in China, that can be freezing cold in the winter and boiling in the summer, but always dry, very little rainfall there. And if you go to Antarctica, which we don't really think of as a desert, that is officially a desert because so little rain or snow falls there, okay, that it's officially a desert. Another thing about deserts would be that they're often sandy or rocky or bare earth. So you may have words down that describe that, and you'd be right. Because there's so little rain, a lot of the plants there struggle to grow. And so in a lot of desert places, you'll find that there's bare earth or sand or rock. Okay, it can make them very dusty places. So those are all good words to describe a desert. Now, if you compare that with a rainforest, it'd be very different. Now, when I was thinking of desert animals that we've got living here at the zoo, then I have chosen the meerkats, okay, because they're everybody's favorite. Okay, I've also chosen the budgies, which we've got down flying in our desert house. We've got over 100 budgies. Okay, and I've got the horned lizard as well. Now, let's look at the rainforest. I want you to do the same thing. I want you to come up with some descriptive words that you think would describe how it feels in a rainforest. What's the environment like? So you've got 15 seconds. If you're with somebody, turn to them and have a little brainstorm. If you're on your own, write some words down, and you've got 15 seconds starting in 3, 2, 1, go. I wish I could see the words that you've written down, but there are some words that stand out. Now, one is that it needs to be wet. It rains in a rainforest pretty much every day. When I worked in the rainforest doing some research, it rained every day just as I finished work. Okay, but basically it rains all the time, and that means there's plenty of water around. Now, the other important thing is that it's warm all year round. So the animals and the plants that live in the rainforest know that it's going to be warm all the time. It was a short stay every day when I worked in the rainforest. I knew what I was going to wear. It's very different from living in Britain. Okay, so the animals and the plants know that they can grow all year round. It's always warm and it's always wet. If we explain the word humid, because there's so much water around, then a lot of rainforests are very humid. If you've had a hot shower and you get out of the shower and you think, oh, God, it's hard to breathe in here, then that's what it's like to be in a humid place. Okay, and rainforests can be really humid. When I was thinking about animals that we have living here at the zoo that would normally live in a rainforest in the wild, there are a few that stood out. So I've chosen three. Now the first is the orangutan. The second are our amazing Sumatran tigers, which have just arrived here at the zoo. And the third group of animals that we've got here at the zoo, which are just beautiful, are the poison dart frogs, and those are found in our amphibian ark. Now those are three very different animals, but in the wild they'd all be found in the rainforest. So remember, that rainforest would be wet all the time, okay, and it would be warm all the time as well. Right, now the third and final habitat we're going to look at today is the savannah. Now we've got one last little task for you to do now, where you've got 15 seconds to think up some key words that are going to describe what the savannah is like. So you've got 15 seconds to describe it. Turn to your friends, write down some answers, starting in 3, 2, 1, go. Now I'm hoping that some of the words that you've come up with are things like rainy, okay, or grass, okay, because those are good words to use when you describe in savannah. Now in savannah, it's not rainy all year round. They get their rain at a certain time of the year. If you've watched The Lion King, then you may well be familiar with this, which is that in the savannah, it rains at a certain time of the year. For the rest of the year, it can actually be quite dry. Okay, and in The Lion King, there's a bit where all the animals are waiting for the rains to come, and they know that when the rains come, the grass is going to grow and there are plenty to eat. And for the animals that live in the real savannah, out in places like Kenya and Tanzania, it can really be like that. It can be quite dry. By the end of the dry season, the grass can all be withering up, but when the rains come, the plants grow back and there's plenty to eat. Okay, it can be hot or cold, depending on what time of year it is. whether it's day or night, and where you are in the world. Okay, but it's just rainy at a certain time of the year. Now, officially, savannah is rolling grassland with just a few scattered trees, okay? And those trees, there can be quite a few of them, okay, but they shouldn't join up to make a canopy. So it's not the same as living in a forest. But if you think of something like one of the scenes from The Lion King, we've got just scattered trees, that's savannah. Now, we're gonna go and see some of our savannah animals. We've chosen just a few. And when I was thinking of the savannah animals that live here at the zoo, I've chosen three for us to look at today. And they're all quite big. So we're going to be looking at giraffes. Rhinos, we've got black rhinos here at Paignton Zoo. And finally, zebras. Now, our zebras in the wild actually would be found up in the mountains, okay, not on the flat grassland. Right, we've got a little fun game to test your knowledge. So have you been listening today? Have you been engaging your brains today? Okay, we've looked at three different habitats. So we've looked at tropical rainforest, desert, and savannah today, and we've chosen some random animals from around the zoo that live in those three different habitats. Okay, and we want you to try and guess which habitat they will be found in the wild. Now, you might be thinking this is going to be difficult, but you can see some clues sometimes in the background, so maybe in the way that we keep them here in the zoo, but also sometimes the animal's color gives an important clue about where it would be found. So if you're looking at the animals, just have a little think. If you've got time, maybe you could write the answers down, or you can tell the person next to you. So you ready? 3, 2, 1, off we go. Now, I've got one big task for you to do today. I want you to draw me a picture that shows you in a habitat in the wild. Now, we've looked at three different habitats today. We've looked at tropical rainforest, savannah, and desert. But I want you to choose one of those that's going to be your place to live in the wild, and I want you to draw me a picture that shows you live in there in the wild. Now, to do that, you're going to have to imagine living there. So maybe you'll need to shut your eyes. Okay, take a little minute and just think about what it would be like to live in that habitat in the wild. So for me, I'd really like to live in the savannah. So I'm going to shut my eyes and imagine living there. And then maybe when I draw my picture, I'll draw me standing in the grass. I can feel the grass tickling my legs. Okay, I can feel the wind in my face. I think maybe there's a cheetah somewhere nearby hiding in the grass. And that's going to be me in the savannah. So I'm going to draw that picture. And I'd like you to write a sentence underneath that describes what it's like to live in that habitat. So maybe I would write underneath, I live in the savannah where I can feel the wind against my face and the dry grass against my legs. Okay, so I'd like you to do that now. Okay, so try and think up a picture and a sentence that describes what it's like to live in those habitats in the wild. I hope you've enjoyed me joining us today here at Paignton Zoo. Okay, and come and see us soon. Cheers.